Hey, Hill.
Hill here.
Gaming.
Welcome back to Mafia 3. This is Hill with another episode. Unfortunately, the last episode, we lost a lot of footage due to a crash to desktop, but we are back now. I did complete South Downs. I was trying to collect money so that I could talk to the boxer up on the roof and, you know, forward the story. All that did happen, unfortunately, off camera. But where we are now, back in South Downs, I need to talk to Donovan so that I can get more information in my mission to kill Tommy Marcano. So it does look like we are getting pretty far here in the game. Let me just show you my kill list here. And if I'm reading this right, it looks like I have eliminated, I guess, the Dixie Mafia. I can actually scroll over this. Roman the Butcher Barbieri has been killed. Frank Pagani has been killed. And Michael Greco has been killed. So next on our list here is Tommy Marcano. And these other people are unknown. Yep, unknown, no intel. All right. Let's go and talk to Donovan now. And if you did miss my video yesterday, they did release a new patch, which has given us some customization options. This is a alternate outfit that Lincoln is wearing with the sleeves cut off of his, combat fatigue looking stuff. So that happened yesterday. The patch addressed some other things like supposedly the gloss and stuff on the cars and whatnot, but nothing significant that I've really seen. No real differences. All right, here we go. Talk to Donovan.
Hey there.
Tommy Marcano brought in a counterfeiter from Cuba, right?
Sal spent a couple of months trying to print the money himself, but none of it was worth a damn. The color was wrong, printing was cockeyed, you name it. He needed someone who knew what the fuck they were doing. So he used his connections and found a man named Alvarez.
And this Alvarez was also counterfeiting money for Castro.
Most of our enemies counterfeit American money. Hell, some of our allies do too.
Sorry, he's gone.
What do you mean he's gone? All you had to do is drive down to the goddamn lighthouse and pick him up.
It's not my fault Alvarez is running all over the goddamn place. I wanted to lock his ass up, but you wouldn't hear of it. The last thing we need is Zaraga finding out that we treated his nephew like dog shit. You understand? Then Lincoln Clay comes in shooting the shit out of everything.
Lincoln Clay. Lincoln Clay. I'm so sick and fucking tired of hearing about this cocksucker. He's just one man. A fucking nigga. We're skating a thin line here, Tommy. You understand? This thing falls apart. We fucked all of us.
So, what the fuck would you do?
What the fuck would I do?
Listen here. This ain't rocket science. If that fucking nigga got to Alvarez, it means he knows about the place. He's gonna come after him, you understand? Get your ass down to that motherfucking gym and protect them.
Yeah, sure. I'm on it.
This shit ends right here, right now. No more fuck-ups.
Fuck me.
According to these reports, Tommy Marcano had the money press in a boxing gym he operated.
Tommy knew Lincoln was coming for the plates, but he felt he had to keep up appearances. The second he started canceling fights and shutting the place down was the second people started thinking he was out of his league. He wasn't about to allow that to happen.
How did Lincoln Clay gain access to the gym?
He had me track down a man named Alcee Bennett. Alcee is a small-time hustler that worked for Sammy until he double-crossed him and was kicked out of the Hollow. After that, he scratched out a living recruiting fighters for Tommy's jungle fights. If he vouched for Lincoln at the door, Lincoln could get in without a big ruckus.
Alcee's by the Briar Patch, not far from here. I'll stop by and say hello, see how he's getting along. Have fun.
Okay, kill Tommy Marcano, the mission called Burn Like Napalm. So we're going to talk to Alcee, and that was one of the other things that happened yesterday. I did rescue this guy. Alvarez, I think his name was. and sent him back to Cuba. He was the guy that was doing the counterfeiting for Marcano. And Marcano's men were coming to kill him. There was a big fight. I'm sorry you guys missed it. Didn't die, not one time. But it's all over. The guy's safe in Cuba. And he did divulge the location of this gym that they're referring to here. And I guess we are going to contact this person here that is going to let us in. So I've been reading a lot of negative press and YouTube videos and stuff about Mafia 3 and the things that are wrong with it. And, you know, even with the flaws of the game, even with the repetitiveness of the game, I'm still enjoying it. So I don't know what that says, but, you know, the combat is fun. It is repetitive, but it's fun. And watching the story unfold is also fun. So that's where I am at the game. I'm still enjoying it. I don't know if it's worth playing another time, a second playthrough, even though we can now, you know, change a few outfits for Lincoln. I just don't know if that's enough. But we'll see. We'll see the outcome. I mean, one thing I will say, if this does happen, we'll probably, you know, I'll be done with the game. But if the main character does die in the end, I really see no point in playing it again. So, you know, no spoilers. Please don't put any spoilers in the comment section. I don't want to know what happens to him. But yeah, that would definitely be a deal breaker for me. They want me to park right here in the open. All right, I guess I don't need to be armed. I'm just coming in here to talk.
Well, fuck me running. If it ain't Lincoln Clay.
Surprised to see me, Alcy?
I heard about Sammy and Ellis. Tough break. I guess you made it out okay.
Speak of them once more, and I'll slice you from ear to asshole. Let's go. We're taking a drive.
Assuming I don't have a choice here.
What do you think?
Lead the way.
He certainly, no love lost for, Sammy and them. Okay. Now, for a moment there, I was not able to control my character. There have just been some really crazy things going on since this last patch.
You know I've stayed away. I ain't stepped foot in the Hollow since November of 62. Almost 6 years.
I know.
Can you at least tell me where we're going?
The Acadia. It's where Tommy Marcano holds his jungle fights, right?
Whoa.
And you've been recruiting black fighters for him.
I have.
Good. Because I want in.
What? Why?
I wanted you to know I'd have told you.
If I'm sticking my ass out like that, I need to know why.
Motherfucker, you lucky to be alive after...
You gonna kill us!
No, I'm not. You better not try to cut me off.
You lucky to be alive after what you did to Sammy. You really think he wouldn't notice you stealing all that money?
Look, I paid for that 100 times over. 6 years banished from the only place I ever call home. Christ. I couldn't even go see my mama on her deathbed.
You made your choice. And now it's time to make another one.
And I do this.
You get a clean slate. Come and go through the Hollow as you please.
Fuck. Okay.
I hear if you win out, Tommy meets you in person. That true?
He likes to size up the winners. See if there's someone he wants to bring on regular. Or if they're just a one-time deal.
Where's this happen?
Usually up there in his office. One of his guys will meet you in the locker room after the fight. He'll take you to timing.
All right.
What is this countdown, time remaining. Oh, come on. Oh, I really don't like that. This is just going to appear on the screen and there's no explanation. What? Why am I have to rush here to meet this guy? To get into a fight? I really don't understand this. You know, and I really feel like taking my time, too, and see what happens if the clock runs out. This is completely unnecessary. Why should there be a timer? And now it's slowing down.
Fires don't take the front entrance. We go in through the side door.
This is crazy. Or is this the time the fight is going to start, like in a minute and 30 seconds? Oh my God, where's the entrance? Oh, it's down here in the... Okay, I got it. I'm still taking my time. I don't appreciate this, Hangar 13, putting a timer on this shit. Excuse me. Don't appreciate this at all. Warning, time is running out. For what? What am I missing here?
Hold up, Alcy. Who the fuck's this?
This is Jackknife Johnson.
What's he here for?
Fuck you mean, what he here for? We here to fight, boy.
Gotta search him. No weapons allowed.
Submit to pat down. Alright, well, I guess this means I'm gonna lose all my guns, huh?
Watch where you put your hands, motherfucker.
Save it for the ring, dipshit. Go ahead.
Where the hell is the locker room? Stuff out here, but this is crazy. Alright, I think we're good now.
Hang back, boys.
Ooh, look at all these... Everybody here? Oh, my powers don't work. My vision.
Let nature take its course.
You good now. Go on.
What the hell? What? Dude, really?
You
know your way around here. I don't.
I gotta go make the arrangements. Give me your name.
Look at all these people. There's no way I'd be able to kill everybody. Change my clothes.
So what happens if we get caught?
Probably what you think.
For a chance to go home again, it's worth it. No matter what happens, we should go.
Enter the ring.
This is it. You nervous?
Should I be?
Guess that depends on where all this ends. You're gonna head through these doors and they announce your name. Then make your way to your corner.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'll meet you there. This part of the show is all about you. They love showing off their fighting niggas.
Go on, they're waiting on you.
And the jungle fights continue, boys! The next challenger to face Nick Boom Boom Beaumont comes in at over 6 feet tall, weighing approximately 220 pounds. This is Jackknife Johnson!
All right. See if I can find my way down here to the ring. I can't jump over the rope.
Fight! What the fuck you call that? motherfucker.
Oh shit, I'm about to die. You kidding me? How do I don't even know what moves to use here. I seem to have one button here. Oh, okay. Well, oh, here we go. I get some health back. Oh, I don't even have health packs.
Our next fighter here is from Buckley Mills. You'll know him as Bobby Ledoux, the beautiful Brawler.
Boom Boom was a paper bag compared to the Brawler. You gotta keep moving and don't let him get you in the corner.
Stay out of the corner. Got it.
Do I have my health back? Okay. Yeah, at least there's that.
Hit him harder.
What the fuck you call that? I said hit that motherfucker.
Trying to stay out of the corner.
Break him in two.
Jack Matt Johnson is on a roll tonight. Next up.
Oh my God, another one. I think I figured this fighting out, but oh man.
Making his way to the ring is the beast of the bayou. The
Lord, who is this?
Your champion, Great Digimon!
You know why they call him Grave Digger.
Because he buries motherfuckers?
Well, yeah.
So how do I beat him?
You hit him really, really hard.
That helps.
Kick his ass. Make him scream. I won't see blood.
This is killing my fingers though, trying to do this.
Champion, Mr. Jack Matt Johnson.
All right. Now what?
To the locker room and collect your winnings.
Where are you heading?
Me? I got business to attend to.
You niggas really know how to brawl. My respect, that's for fucking sure. Lucky.
You must think I'm some kind of goddamn moron coming in here like you did.
I
I've never been one to shy away from a calculated risk.
Maybe you should have. I'll mix some vegetable oil in. Makes the gasoline thick. Sticky. We're just gonna let it soak in a little bit. Work his way into every nook and cranny. That way when I light it, that shit's gonna burn like napalm.
And you. You are gonna hurt like no one's hurt before.
Fuck you.
Guess you ready to die.
You still be conscious as the flames creep up your legs. But as they bind, you be hit in the
shit.
Sickening revelation. Before you die, you gonna feel your pecker burn. It's gonna curl and twist.
Gonna hand you, pal.
Larry, fire it, Larry.
This dude.
We can work something out.
Only thing needs working out of your funeral arrangements.
Is this it? This was the main dude right here I just shot? Tommy Marcano? Just for the hell of it. You sit there and suffer for a little bit. Let me see. Is there anything else in here? You want a shot of adrenaline? That might help you. What is it? Is there any extra money in here? Anything for me? I'm giving you time to recover. There's money, but I can't take it. Oh, this might be counterfeit. I probably don't want it anyway. Yeah, this is all this counterfeit stuff. Okay. All right, well, Mr. Marcano, let's see what you got to say.
So that's that, then.
Sure looks that way.
You know, Sal wanted me to go to law school, work for some big company, maybe run for office. Do something decent with your goddamn life, you understand?
Should've listened to him.
It's in the blood, you know.
Yeah. You are who you are. No point in arguing with yourself about it.
Fuck you. Like this. Not like this!
Don't worry. Lou and Sal will be along shortly.
No. He's coming for us.
Come back. Spotted him. This way.
Taking my shot.
Gonna bury you, asshole. Hey,
get ready.
Oh, shut up.
Cover my ass.
Keep your own damn Molotov.
Heads off, Molotov!
Okay, good. My Hornet vision is back.
We got ourselves a guest.
Alright, there doesn't seem to be a timer like before, so I can take my time getting out of here. Let's see.
cells of gas.
Running for cover. Light it.
Get your ass around him!
Say goodbye, motherfucker.
It's all yours, boys.
Get him down!
I got you covered!
Now who's shooting at me?
Grabbing cover!
Alright, here they come.
Barbecue that bastard! Warming him up!
I'm on to you, buddy.
The street is over that way, okay. Alright, we're running low on bullets here. Really?
Grab some cover.
That's him.
No! Another one. Let me see your insides.
Get this money here. Money here. Oh, I don't think they know where I am. Now he does.
Need to reload.
That's another one. Anybody gonna shoot that asshole?
With pleasure.
Is it just you that's left? Okay. How are we gonna play this? Long distance?
Reload.
Whoa! Really? I don't know what kind of gun that was. Oh, he's got one of those marksman rifles.
Yeah, maybe I'll just close my eyes for a second.
Yeah, like forever. These rifles are kind of dangerous here. All right, only got 4 bullets left. Hopefully, I can exit out of here now. Oh shit, what's this? All right, got to break out the other gun. Shit! Really? Oh my god. Shouldn't there be some warning or something? Well, at least I... Where the hell am I?
Fuck you!
fuck? Get him!
Really? Oh, they're trying to make this interesting, I see.
I'm empty! Slip behind him!
I'm up still over here! Crew! Don't ease up on the trigger!
He ain't going nowhere!
Is there anybody behind me?
Getting out of here!
Load up a fucking Molotov!
Warming him up!
Need to reload.
It's still coming. Okay, we're gonna do it this way, okay? Is there anybody else that needs tending to? Make sure I got all the money. Pick up an extra med kit. What else have we got? Looks like you could use another one. Okay. It's a good thing you passed on. Oh, shit. More? Leave now.
I'll put you down.
Oh my God, really?
Take cover.
Barbecue that bastard.
Warming him up.
All right, he doesn't really know where I am. Just this one dude, or am I gonna run up here and then a whole bunch of them are gonna come out again?
Ain't fucking here, then I don't fucking care. Did everybody ditch me?
Dude, this is not gonna go well for you. Now, can I leave this place in peace? There's somebody else out here that wants to die.
Go
3-5. Oh, fuck.
Responding unit investigating.
Really? And I'm got, look at this, dead. Really? Now, they better, the checkpoint had better be from when I come out the door and get to get into the car.
Available unit. Suspicious individual on foot. Officers investigating.
And it takes so fucking long to start this car. Oh, damn it. The tires are out. Get the hell out of my way. I did read somewhere where there are no police in boats in the game, except in the very beginning, so you can always jump in the water to get away. Let's hope this is true. I got a lot of swimming to do. Because I don't know, this circle seems to be so big. What? Knowing my luck. Is it? Are these cops? Okay, good. No. So they know I'm here. Wow. Oh, I do see the edge of the circle though. Not sure if I should try to swim for it or just wait a little longer. Because they keep saying I'm not here. Let me keep swimming for the circle. The edge. Look, is this a police boat? Please tell me they weren't lying. No, I guess these are just regular boats. I don't see, I mean, they should have lights on them if they were the police.
All units, negative visual on
yeah. All right, we did it.
What happened to the money plates that Sal Marcano stole from the Federal Reserve?
I don't recall.
Georgie, get your ass in here. Your Uncle Tommy's dead. I thought you'd like to know.
Sorry, Pops. I know what he meant to you.
He was a smart kid, your Uncle Tommy. Could have been anything. I tried to tell him, go to college. Even offered to pay for it. Instead, he went to Cuba.
It's not your fault.
Yeah. Well, we're pretty well fucked now, you understand? And I was counting on that counterfeit money without it. Hell.
Well, now there's gotta be something we can do. You go put the squeeze on people. Get to increase what they're kicking up.
It ain't gonna be enough. Just because you poke holes in someone doesn't mean you're gonna get anything extra out of them.
You could always call Leo Galante. Ask him to front...
Fuck him! The whole reason I'm building this goddamn casino is to get out from under them worthless fucks. Not bringing the commission, they're gonna want to cut everything. God damn it. Go on, get the hell out of here. I gotta make a call. Get out! Leo! How the fuck are you? It's Sal. Yeah? Listen, I got something I need to discuss.
I tried to reconcile the part of me that helped Lincoln with the part of me that vowed to follow the teachings of Jesus Christ. But I can't. You know what I remember? I remember watching the news and learning they had gunned down Dr. King. I remember watching people lash out, riot, because that's all they had left. All the while, Lincoln's in the other room, barely clinging to life. Maybe that's why I did what I did.
All right, Tommy Marcano is dead. And now we're having a sit down.
Let's find out how you're gonna screw me this time.
Oh boy.
South Downs belongs to us. Tommy was smart and set up some solid, low-key rackets there. Should be a smooth transition for us.
You and me were already tied together in this, seeing as how I'm running most of the city for you. Going someplace else? Let's just say I can be the jealous type.
You got yourself an opportunity here. A chance to right some missteps on your part. I got no part of this district, but you can change that, and you'd be a smart motherfucker to do so. The Irish can work this district better than any other.
Folks back in the holler are starting to wonder what's going on. It's time we show them how we become stronger when we work together.
I'm towing the line, Lincoln.
Oh, good lord.
That's gotta mean something.
All right, so...
You cooked things up this far, but you can still make it right between us.
Man, so if I go with him, I'm going to lose my stamina and recovery boost.
I done my best to honor Perla. Can you return the favor?
Wow.
Give me the keys to the kingdom, partner.
prove you're worth a damn, Lincoln.
Man, I really want that stamina and recovery boost, though. I don't want to lose that.
So what's it going to be, Chief?
Wow, these people are going to be pissed at me.
Expect us to stick together.
Yeah, I know.
Hello, fucking around. Where are you landing?
All right, I've got to go with Burke. I mean,
it's never an easy answer. Trust me, I know.
Yeah, thank you, Burke. I'm sorry, Vito. I have to go with Vito.
Gonna need Vito to run this turf.
I've had enough of this shite. You're a lying, cheating bastard for dragging me into this. You preyed on my fucking sympathies, and I'll never forgive you for it.
Come on, Irish. Relax. You've been around the block enough to know it's just business.
There's only so much shitting on an Irishman can take before he wipes it from his eyes and comes at you with both barrels. I see you clearly now, Lincoln, and it's time you made this right.
Never thought I'd say this, but Burke's right. You can't keep leading us on like this, Lincoln. Not for much longer.
You made your point, Burke. Now that's enough. Y'all don't have to like the decisions I make. And to be honest, your egos are the least of my fucking concerns. Way I see it, you fall in line or you fall out altogether. Now let's go make some fucking money.
All right, this is looking like the last time I'm going to be able to give Vito any more of these districts without losing, you know, probably both Burke and Cassandra. So I'll have to be careful, but I really like having my stamina and all that kind of stuff because I like fighting up close and personal when it is possible. Okay, well, we've let this video run on for quite some time. I'm going to end it here. I hope you enjoyed it. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing. And you can also follow me on Twitter. I have daily gaming news. And thank you for watching. And I will catch you guys in the next video.